all this talk about pretty sword boys is exciting, but let's be real, guys. This is the true pretty boy right here. Hey there, guys. John here, bringing you another news update for the world of Card Fight Vanguard. So, Japan just have their Dai Vangasai currently happening at the moment. They've got a lot of cool events that are currently going on, but for us, more importantly, I think we care about more so the card reveals than anything else. And actually, there's a lot to talk about here. Well, I mean, I say a lot, but there's a good amount that I'd like to talk to you guys about. Of course, there are more Touken Ranbu reveals, so we got more Sword Boy action going on. But more importantly, and why I'm super hyped, are these guys. Guys, we finally have some reveals for effects for Monster Strike, guys. The more and more I think about it, the more excited I get for Monster Strike, because this, the overall concept is so unique that I can't wait to see what they do from here. And by the looks of these effects, guys, I'm actually very excited. So we're going to be going over all of that and a few more. But of course, guys, if you like this style of content, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe, as it does help the channel and we greatly appreciate it. But I'm just going to get right into it, guys, because there is a few things to talk about. So of course, guys, we're going to go right for the Sword Boy ride line right off the bat. And the first one is this guy over here, the Mutsu no Koyami Yoshiyuki. Again, apologize if I'm not proficient in Sword Boy language. But anyway, just a generic grade 0 D starter, not much to say. But he does have the ride line, which we are going to talk about now. And his grade 1 is this one over here, the Yoshiyuki Sento. So the ability reads, when this unit is rode upon by Toku, which is his grade 2 version, choose up to one of your opponent's back row rear guards and retire it. So we're getting some retire action going on now in Touken Ranbu. And if it's not retired, Soul Charge 1. So this effect is pretty simple and straightforward, you know. I don't see an opponent actually calling down as many back row rear guards to be aggressive on the early game. However, if they do, they will get punished. So this just seems more like a free soul charge than anything else. And its other effect reads, during your turn, this unit gets power plus 2000. So it's a solid 10k beater on your part, as well as a 10k booster. So it makes nice numbers, which is actually really nice for Touken Ranbu. Touken Ranbu, the more and more we're playing around with it, it's good to see that the overall concept is you want to make solid numbers and you benefit off making solid numbers and pressuring your opponent. So overall, very solid card and nice for the red line. So now let's talk about the grade 2 version of the Yoshiyuki, and that is going to be the Yoshiyuki Toku. So this ability reads, when this unit is rode upon by the Kiwame, which is the grade 3 version of Yoshiyuki, Soul Blast 1, choose one of your opponent's back row rear guards and retire it. And if you did not retire, draw a card. I see this more as, if your opponent knows that you're playing this particular ride line, they're not going to try and invest that much into their backboard during the early game. And if they do, they will get punished. So this is actually just a nice free draw card than anything else, which is kind of nice. And then its other ability reads, during your turn, this unit gets plus 2k. So it's another 12k beater. Match this up with a 10k booster. It is a 22. It is a bit kind of meh when you think about it like that, because when it comes to overdress, the magic numbers are going to be for the 13 gate bases, the 13s, the 23s, the 18s, anything like that to help make solid pressure and to make more magic numbers is always nice to ask for more guard in the hand. So in that sense, this is kind of meh. If it was a plus 3k, it would be a lot better, but alas, it is a plus 2k, and as it stands right now, the card is just okay, in my opinion. And then the last Sword Boy that they revealed was his grade 3 super duper version, which is the Kiwame. And the Kiwame reads, if your opponent does not have any regards in their back row, this unit gets power plus 2000. That's actually really good for a grade 3, because making 15k plus an AK booster makes 23, which is very solid numbers in its own right. But it doesn't stop there, folks. So he has another ability that says auto, when this unit attacks, counterblast 1, choose one of your opponent's back row rear guards and retire it. Then for each of your opponent's open back row rear guard circles, this unit gets power plus 5,000 until the end of that battle. So guys, if your opponent has no backboard while you're on this Kiwame, then this unit receives a plus 15k boost plus the additional 2k, making it without Persona Ride a 30k plus booster, 38k. Very, very nice. That is a solid amount of guard for your opponent to be responding to. And on a Persona Ride turn, it's even more. So they're most likely going to be perfect guarding. And in that sense, if they do manage to call a backboard, of course, it's going to be a lot less. But you do have ways of punishing them based on the Yoshiyuki ride line. Overall, I think it's very solid. We'll have to wait to see if there's any more retiring potential, because as it stands right now, yes, it is solid and it does make good numbers. But if your opponent doesn't call any backboard in the early game and then responds by calling backboard in the late game and you have no way to retire it, then the effect becomes a little less powerful in that sense. It doesn't become as pressuring. But if there is more ways to retire the opponent's backboard, then this actually becomes a very solid card in my eyes. So time will tell to see where they take it from here. Alrighty, and that'll do it for all the Sword Boy news. And now let us talk about what I'm very excited about, and that is the Monster Strike reveals. So the first one they revealed was, for, of course, for the first version of the trial deck, which is Excalibur, and it is the main grade 3 himself, True Sacred Sword of Bonds Excalibur. So first of all, the art is actually pretty cool. I like the fact that, you know, it's, you know, a whole bunch of like Gilgamesh, a whole bunch of different types of weapons going on. So that's really, really cool in my opinion. I personally don't play Monster Strike, so maybe I don't know as much. I don't know if this is like a main character or anything like that. I just think he looks really cool. Anyway, his effect reads, continuous Vanguard Circle. During the battle that this unit attacked, this unit gets power plus 10k. So just a 23k solid number right off the bat. No modifiers, nothing like that, no conditions. He's just a 23k when you attack the Vanguard. Overall, really nice, makes really good numbers. And then his other ability reads, auto, when this unit attacks a Vanguard, if you Persona Road this turn, counterblast one, discard a card, choose one of your rear guards, and stand it. So it is a way to enable multi-attacks. So now Monster Strike has a way to enable multi-attacks. And if you guys know, in the world of Overdress, in my personal opinion, multi-attacks are very powerful. Having the ability to restand key units, and then those key units have to either respond with a way to pressure your opponent, and if they ask for a certain amount of guard, it makes more magic numbers, it creates more pressure, and overall, I think it's actually very powerful. Whether that means that this will have influences in the meta, of course, time will tell. As it stands right now, it's just the grade 3 by itself, but I see this just based on how I'm reading Excalibur at the current moment. It has ways to not only enable multi-attack, but it has ways to power up the board, perhaps, and then those create more pressure, and then that creates more guard pressure, and then therefore that creates a lot more of a pushing play style to overwhelm your opponent. So I'm a personal fan of those types of cards. Very Bastion-like when you think about it. Actually, you know, that's actually a very good way to think about this particular card. Think of it like Bastion Light. Whether that means it'll directly influence and reflect it, time will tell. But overall, solid card in my opinion, especially for just a trial deck card. However, as good as this card is, holy moly, this next card just blew my expectations away, guys. So let's talk about it. And that is the other grade 3 for the other trial deck for Monster Strike, and that is Laplace, Demon of Causality. So she reads, when this unit is boosted, attacks a Vanguard, counterblast one and soul blast one, choose up to three of your opponent's rear guards and retire them. So off just one skill alone, it is a free, basically pseudo board wipe. Three rear guards is very powerful, especially in Overdress when you're talking about multi-attack units like Bastion and multi-attack units like Magnolia, and really overwhelms them with sheer just retire power. It's very, very, very good. Anyway, and then its other effect reads, if you Persona Road this turn, cost, discard one, choose one of your opponent's Vanguards, and its power is reduced to zero until the end of turn. So now she has a pseudo zeal effect, which is absolutely insane. So it's control as well as more control in terms of asking your opponent for more guard, more pressure, and overall more just affluence in terms of board presence in general. It's a very, very scary card, guys. And if there's more support to come with this, that means there's going to be more controlling aspects, and then maybe there might be some cards that get power when your opponent is at zero power, and then maybe she has ways to affluence certain forms of the game state when it comes to just overwhelming your opponent with absolute, basically, deletion powers. It's kind of crazy. Board wipe, zeal power, overall, super big fan of this card. And everybody, that's kind of the news actually this week. Overall, it was very short, to be honest. There was only a few reveals, so not much else to say about it. But with the two cards that were released for Monster Strike especially, I'm very excited to see where they're going to go from here, because of course these effects are very powerful, but how will that also directly interact with the gacha system of Monster Strike? Time will tell, and I'm very excited to see where they'll go from here. And I think what's going to be happening is they're going to have next Wednesday a live stream where they're going to be announcing future product as well as more cards, so I'm definitely going to be going over that as well. And I might ask Henry to shift around the market watches and or maybe release it on Friday. Let me know actually in the comments down below if you guys want to see that particular video at a certain day. I'm more excited to go over that. And of course, I'm willing to be very flexible with that. But overall, guys, that is just going to do it for me for the week. Very quick. What do you guys think of all these reveals? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm also very curious. But with that being said, guys, my name is John from Team Gradelock. Hope you guys are going to have a good day today. And I will see you guys next time. Deuces!